Hi, y'all. You're watching the Youth Media Channel, and today we're taking you on a special trip to the Bronx. Come on.
Men, women, police officers, and children gathered at the Kips Bay Boys and Girls Club to play basketball and socialize at the second annual Community Hoops event, organized by Race for Reentry. The nonprofit organization is a collaborative effort in order to raise awareness and provide solutions for communities impacted by incarceration. Here's Charles Simmons, a community activist and referee for the day's games.
It's a lot of things that we do in the community to give back to the community. And today, just a fun day. That games was going great. You know, we had the NYPD play against the community hoops, and now we got the wheelchair playing against the NPD.
We've been playing since about 10 a.m. We're going to be going to about 4 p.m. So, yeah, it's a whole day thing.
Officer Velez works in the 43rd Precinct and patrols the Kips Bay Soundview area. He's also a part of the Police Athletic League, which promotes interaction between officers and kids through sports.
A lot of the kids, I want to say up to like 18-year-olds, they're here. They're here most of the week. So the Kips Bay, they invited us to have a good time with them for today.
Alberto Rodriguez is the program director at the Kips Bay Boys and Girls Club. As a Bronx native, he's seen the difference community programs can make.
I did grow up in this neighborhood, right up the block in the Castle Hill Projects. Have I seen a change? Of course, through progression, there's always changes, good, bad, or indifferent. But, you know, to get away from your question, that's what we're here for, a safe haven to provide programs, activities to assist these kids with development and give them tools to grow. Have I seen changes? Sure, I have seen changes, yes.
Rodriguez notes that while there was some turbulence in hosting the event, it all came together in the end.
Unfortunately, the other facility that she had planned for fell through. So, come on, it's a no-brainer. We're trying to do something for the community. We're one of the community-based organizations. So she came to us, and I made things happen. Or we make things happen, you know, because of the special event. The kids benefit, the community benefits, so it's a win-win situation.
Minister Kwame and Kayan Reed Sr. both work for Stand Up for Violence and came out to show support for Race for Reentry.
We like to do a lot of community events to bridge the gap between community, police officers, community, elected officials. So that's one of the main reasons we're out here today, to show our support for Jen.
Many audience members were excited during the youth game as the Bronx Mathematics Prep basketball team, New York Edge, took home another victory.
They have some athletes out there, whatever like that, so it's some pretty young talent, but they're up-and-come talent. They look pretty good out there.
We blew them out. We smacked them.
Yeah.
Y'all won?
Yeah, by like 30. Nah, it was like 60 to like 25.
And how long y'all been playing together?
Like 4 years now.
Some team members have known each other since childhood and have noticed breakthroughs in their teamwork after years of playing together.
Coach helped us get a lot better.
Yeah, well, coach helped us get a lot of chemistry better over the 4 years.
The wheelchair basketball team, the Brooklyn Nets, also took home a victory against the 43rd Precinct, with Ernell Samuels as a forward and a star shooter. He's been on the team for a few years and also sees a change in his relationship to other members.
It's been fun. It's been a rough road. We started off real bad, but we've been getting better and better over time. A lot of growing pains, a lot of learning each other in each other's games.
What's one conflict that y'all really grew through that stuck out to you, that you were like, oh, wow, we're a team now?
Lack of communication. We communicate a lot now. We talk to each other on and off the court, and we hang out more of a family-wise.
Off the court and in the club's performance hall, actor, singer, and dancer Carlos Carrera, a.k.a. CJ, has been making a name for himself in the entertainment industry. The 10-year-old recently left a 7-month tour of Gloria Estefan's On the Road and is now back at the Boys and Girls Club, where he took his first dance classes at 6 years old.
Do you have any future projects coming up?
So I've been going to a lot of auditions, and I've been getting a lot of callbacks, but like I just came off of SNL, Saturday Night Live. So it was like really fun. I can't wait like to the future. Like, what am I gonna do in my future? Because I also want to help kids, like other people in the Boys and Girls Club.
Marta Valencia has worked at this Boys and Girls Club location for 25 years and is now the food program services coordinator. She helps feed over 135 kids who visit the club every day and knows them by heart.
So I'm so happy because it's not like help the kids, but I just be friends with them, you know. And so many kids, they really need the love, the attention, they don't have it at home. And I think this is a play to save the kids being out of the streets.
Marta isn't the only one keeping the masses fed. The Community Hoops event also provided a meal to the attendees that won their hearts and stomachs.
How was the food?
It was buzzing. It was blessing. It was blessed. It was blessed. It was blessed.
Yeah. What was on your plate?
Now I had some plantains, some rice and beans, some chicken.
Arroz con habichuela, el pollo, and empanadillas. Come on, they were banging.
All in all, it was a good time for everyone and shows the positive benefits of keeping a community engaged and together.
Wow, wasn't that a fun event and all for a good cause? If you want to stay involved, follow us on social media for community updates. Thank you for watching. I'll see you later.